It is your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Ark Survival Evolved Pooping Evolved server. I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. Been doing a little bit more building down here, trying to get some stuff and things to look the right way. This was a bit of a challenge as well, guys. We had a challenging episode. Well, I can't. Oh, yeah, that's right. You can't get off. I forgot. On the elevator. So it's been a bit of a challenging episode, the last episode. Little frustrations with some building, but we're working through it. We're getting stuff and things done. And now I have placed the elevator. And even though these guys, none of these guys, foundations or ceilings or nothing like that, will snap to the elevator, I have made it fit, I hope. We won't know for sure if this is going to work out until we can move this bad boy around. So yeah, I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a great day. I wanted to tell you guys thank you so much for all your support and all the ARK videos. It continues to be an amazing thing, and it's all because of you guys. So yeah, thank you very much for hitting the like button. If you like this video, don't forget to smash the like button for me. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more daily ARK stuff and things, Mad Max stuff and things. We got Survival of the Fittest on the way now. It's going to be some new games coming up. Keep in mind, peeps, and in about a week or so, we are going to slow down a little bit. I'm going to be getting ready to go to a vacation. So we'll be having maybe one video a day or some stuff and things like that. Don't worry. You'll still get your Slip Gator fixed. I'll still be here. Might just be a little bit different. So, all right, we're going to turn this guy on right here. We're going to go to Structures Electrical. We're going to go ahead and build a generator to start off with. We need one of these to start playing around with some stuff and things. So we're going to get our Jenny right there. We need one of these guys. We need actually a little bit of wood. And we need some vertical electric stuff and things. So I'm thinking we might actually run multiple generators. I don't know. I don't know if we want to try to run this all off one Jenny for the whole build or run a Jenny specifically for the elevator. That seems kind of silly, doesn't it? Well, for nowsies, we can always rebuild. Let's go ahead and go into the structures electrical again, and let's get, how many of these guys can we make? Add one? Oh, we can make over 100? Let's make a few. There we go. And then we need some wood in order to get that guy going, so we need a couple electrical boxes too. I want to get this elevator online right away today. I want to test it out and see what kind of cool stuff we're going to be able to do. And I'm also a little bit concerned that when it goes down, it's going to clip. Can I fly on you with 100 wood on the double? Oh, yeah, baby. You're super powerful, kind of. All right. So, yeah, I'm concerned that once we rise the elevator up, it will not rise back down again. So let's squirt that wood in there. Structures, electrical. Let's grab one, two of these guys. And then we have, what, 9 of those? Let's build a few more. 6 like that. So now we got 2 of those bad boys. We got 10 of these bad boys and a couple more that are being created. Let's go over here. Well, actually, I gotta wait to turn off my fabricator. But once we are done to the fabricator, we're gonna turn it off. Nailed it, it can't be stopped. Can we carry all of this on you? So amazing. So what we're gonna do is come over here real quick. And let's have a look at where we can place this Jenny. Now I'm thinking what I want to try to do is squirt it down like right. Oh no. I was thinking right over here. Oh wait, yeah, I think it needs to get placed on. Oh yeah, it's gonna need to be placed on a foundation or a ceiling. It's not, it will it just place on the ground? Oh, it will just place on the ground, but it won't place over here. And unfortunately, it looks like that it does want to snap to this. Oh, that would be cool if it would be like right inside there. Oh, right there it is. That would be perfect if we could snap it right there, but it won't place. You know, it'd be really great to see something like where the ground would come up to meet the bottom and allow you to place it. Something like in Subnautica, how that happens. That would be really, really cool. I think it would be difficult for the ARK guys to do. It's a little bit different of a game, but that would be really cool. All right, so let's take a look here and see. We have a couple of foundations. If we squirt one of these down over here like this, is there any spot we can make this go? It's right near here because I don't want to have to run cabling. What I wanted to do is just place it and then run the cabling straight up the back. But it doesn't look like it's going to allow me to do that. Let me see. Anything? No, floor's obstructed. We could do it right over here. And that's not the worst thing that ever happened, but also not the best thing that ever happened. For the purposes of the video, let's just get this done. So let's take a look here and let's place this bad boy like this right over here. Like so. For now. We may move it in the future, but for now, it's a thing. Now, this means that we're going to have to get a couple more wires built, because now we've got to kind of go sideways and over and around and through and all that stuff. So, All right, let's pop down inside of here. I'll go ahead and turn my fabricator back on. I'm going to make a couple more wires. And then we will BRBs, peeps. BRBs! And we're back. Going to grab some gasoline. I got some wiring stuff and things done. Let's have a look here. Wait, what? Where's all my gas at? Hello, the gas. Let's just put 100 in. Why wouldn't we? So, all right, let's check up over into this early direction. This is where we've got our little Jenny right down here. Everything's looking pretty great. Let's go over here. I'll show you what we got going on here. So there we go. Turn on. We got power. So I did a little one of these because I couldn't do a straight because it hit the land or whatever. And then we went up there. And then I've got a junction box right there and a junction box all the way at the top. It's kind of hard to see. It's up there. Watch this. Oh, yeah, right there. There it is. So, I want to tell you guys really quickly. The other last episode where I killed that RG, I said that I thought that there was a bug with what's going on with the guns. And actually, somebody left a comment. Crap, I can't remember who it was. And they had said what it was that when I died and I hit take all, it doesn't, like, differentiate between the two guns in my inventory and just orders them in some order, which seems to oftentimes be backwards from the normal order that I have them. So, actually not a bug. Just an idiosyncrasy of the game is exactly what it was. So, but yeah, so that was what went on there. And it was a whoops. You know, what can you do? Stuff happens. It's hard. So, all right, elevate. We're elevating. We're going up. Oh, my God. We're becoming elevated. It's a thing. This is really slow. This needs a turbo boost. Are we going to go all the way to the top? Who knows? Check back next time on the next episode. No, I'm just kidding. And does it go all the way up? Oh, yeah, baby, it does. So it goes up a little bit higher than it should, or that I would love, that I would like it to. So we could de-elevate, and we could stop. Oh, it's really hard to, like, stop at a specific spot. But it really won't matter, I don't think. We should be able to walk dinos up and down that one little spot. So the next thing is, let's de-elevate and see what goes on here. What happens if we jump when we're de-elevating? Oh, it's okay. It's kind of fun. All right, it's a thing. But what I'm interested to see is, will this de-elevate down and fit nice and snugly into the little home that I've made for it? Or will it kind of stop? Oh, no, it snugly fits. Perfect. That's baller. Nail the nice to camera stop. Thumbs up, smash it, peeps. We did it. No, because actually, normally, or what can happen, and I think it actually maybe. I don't know. What can happen is if you do put, like, ceilings or floors or anything, even a wire or anything that obstructs this, it won't work. It won't stop. I don't think I have a way to demonstrate this to you right now. Maybe I do. Let me see here. Can we put... Will it go the other direction? No, we would need an intersection. Anyway, if you were to put anything under this elevator, it wouldn't fit here. So, we know it fits. It's pretty baller. That's really great. Now, we can continue to move on with moving all of our stuff and things. Now, the tough part about this is this elevator doesn't move quite as fast as I would like. I wish it was a little bit quicker, but nah, you know what? What can you do? So, all right. So this is a thing. Now, the other thing I want to test really quickly, let me see here. I want to go and get a storage something. I want to see, I don't know if you can. This is a good question for me to answer to myself. Let's go ahead in here. Let's look for storage. And we need some thatch and some fiber. I just want to build a box. So let's go ahead and grab this thatch. And let's go ahead and grab this fiber. Like so. Craftables. Storage. Let's just build this. I want to see, and I'm not sure if you can, place one of these on the elevator. So let's go find out. So we got this guy out right here. Because I was thinking it would be kind of neat if we placed the vaults on here. All right, you can't. So you can place it on there, but you can't actually place it on the elevator. It would have been sweet to place a vault right on the elevator, or two vaults, because that way what we could do is, like, move items into the vault and then move it all the way up. Because I'm thinking what we're going to turn this bottom area into here is, like, our loading and unloading area. So kind of a spot that has vaults on the sides, and we can walk a dino up inside of here and move stuff and things around. I think we're going to end up putting... a smithing type area place thing down over here, in this area, and then in this area over here, I can't decide what we're going to do over there. Something cool. Maybe you could put a suggestion in the down there for a specific type of area that we'd like to have over there. Well, right here is our loading and unloading zone. Now, this is going to look a little bit wacky too, because once we cover it with, we'll have to replace all the pillars first, And then once we cover it with metal, there will be a little bit of a dip here. So there'll be a depression where the elevator is as opposed to it being completely even. But it won't be that bad. It'll look good. So, and then as far as the electricity goes, we may change that in the future too, because I would like to have a single generator to power everything in the base. So we'll see how that works out moving forward. But anyway, at the very least, the elevator situation, the elevator sitch is pretty well squared away. I'm pretty excited about it. I'm going to move this guy. Oh, baby, two more Stego eggs. We've been getting a lot of these guys recently. Like, when I first did the Stego farm, I was a little bit disappointed. There was, like, really no eggs. Oh, he's too fat. It's too many eggs. So there really was no eggs for, like, a couple of days. And then suddenly it just kind of picked up. And we got all that kibble the other day, which I made all up. And we've already got, let me take a look here and see, four more Stego eggs. So we're killing it in the Stego egg department. Oh, and how much RG kibble do we have right now? Or Stego kibble, pardon me. We have 9. So I could make 4 more. We'd have 13. And that would be plenty to tame any RG. All right, so I'm thinking the next step in the building process for today will be for us to go ahead and extend this out a bit. Extension is big enough. That is big enough for us to fit like a Bronto on it. And then we'll have to build some ramps down a little bit. So I'm going to place some stuff and things. I got a bunch of it already built over here on tonnage. Check it out, peeps. I got another 76 thatch roofs and 64 wooden pillars. So I'm going to get to building all that stuff, and then I will be our bees, peeps. I'm just a thatch machine. Fine, I don't thatch for nobody but you. That's bad. I'm just a thatch machine. Pardo, just own it. Gonna work for nobody but you. That's right. I'm a thatch machine. I'm a thatch machine. No work. For, that was a little bit over the board. I'm no wanna work for nobody but you. Bow, bow, bow. I'm just a thatch machine. Give me that thatch or I'll give it, feed you to a T-Rex. Mm. This song is really bad. Ow. And we're back. And we're back. And we're going to run our Bronto up here, baby. Oh, yeah. This thing's pretty big. This platform's not humongous, but it is pretty big. Can we move? I mean, is it possible? Is it even a thing that can happen? Can we get him right over here? There we go. Back it up. Beep, 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 beep. I mean, he's pretty much on the platform, right? I don't know. Are you even on here? Are you even... Is the weight show? It says it'll do it! No way! Are we gonna really lift it? Slow mobility off the ground? I can't even imagine this is gonna be a thing. Let's see. Oh my god! It's happening! This elevator is the most powerful elevator in the world! We can't... Now today's day can't be stopped! I can't even believe it! I'm so afraid right now. Oh, did it just break? Did you hear that? I feel like maybe there's a creak. Oh, I can't move. Okay, now I can. I know it's scary, man! Did you hear him? He was like, oh, I'm gonna poop my pants! Oh my gosh. Let's go down here so we can get a better view. A better view of what we've just done. This is unbelievable. Now, I don't think we'll ever take a Bronto up there for real. Like, I think the biggest thing we'd ever want to bring up is a mammoth. But I thought it would just be fun for us to check out here really quickly. Let's go ahead and let's grab stupid big pigeon and have a fly around here and take a look at it. Oh, baby, look how amazing it is. Oh, he's pooping off the top. He pooped himself. He's so freaked out. Don't be freaked out, slow mobility. It's totally fine. I can't even believe that's a thing that just happened. Can you bring it down from up top? I don't think you can. I think you have to be on the platform. If we come over here, can we? Oh, we can de-elevate from here. Let's fly out and watch this thing happen. Look at him go. It shouldn't be a thing. Oh, that's so cool, man. He's so huge. It's crazy. All right, so he's down. There's this little poop. Dude, that's the highest poop you've ever pooped. Could you imagine being a Bronto and then suddenly being like two Brontos, like three Brontos in the air? I'm sure that's quite frightening for a Brontosaurus. I'm sorry, buddy. I didn't mean to scare the poop out of you. Are you okay? I feel like he'll be okay. Give him a couple of days. Just, you know, just getting your feet wet with heights, man. I mean, you're up pretty high already. You know, you're slow mobility. But anyhoozle. So over here, I was doing the building. And, of course, ran into another building snafu, which I seem to have been doing so many times recently. And this has happened to me last season as well. But there's a spot over here where I just can't place a ramp. There's no real reason why. It just says it's obstructed. And I can't really not place it. And I was actually thinking, I was like, you know what I'll do? I'll take a look underneath the world and just see, like, is there something there or any reason why that this is, like, I can't place it? And I don't see any reason why it's not placeable. It just looks like it intersects with too much of the ground. So what I'm hoping is when, because eventually what we're going to do, I mean, we're going to recover it. We're going to cover all this stuff with metal. We're going to change all these pillars out with metal pillars, and we're going to cover all these other. So I'm hoping that when we do that, we'll be able to put the ramp here because, I mean, there's nothing I can do about it. Like, there's just no, there's no fix. There's no change. There's no nothing. And it's not because it isn't supported or anything like that. Now, you may ask yourself, self, Slipgator, how did you get these ramps to be so long? You need to have supports for that. So what I did underneath here is I built a little support structure off of these pillars, brought them out a little bit, and built some additional pillars. This actually right here, I do believe, is technically connecting to the ground. I'd like to place another pillar under it, but it won't. It won't in that spot. It won't place. So I think I could maybe get it if I did like a bunch of tries. Let me here. Let me grab like, oh, I already have some. So I'll show you guys what it looks like when I try to place a pillar here. I get this. So then you can see it kind of goes green sometimes. There, I just replaced the not pillar. There, nailed it. It can't be stopped. Sometimes if you have a problem like that, just so you know, you just kind of have to try it a few times. And I tried it like for a couple minutes and gave up. But then I just, you know, came back to it and we're good to go now. So we've got this huge platform now. We've got all this. I was thinking about starting to getting into the vaults today, but I don't think we have enough metal to do that. So what I was thinking we would do instead is kind of continue to build up. And what I wanted to do is put a ceiling on this place. So I'm thinking I got to get, you know what I do is I got to get William Shatner over here to kind of get an idea of how tall I want this place to be. But I don't think we're going to do walls. And I don't think we're going to do walls on a lot of what we build here. Perhaps in some spots, but I don't really feel like we need a lot of walls. I want to be able to fly in and out of spots really easily. And so I don't think we're going to need it. But if we walk him up here like this, with him actually standing. Okay, he's sinking. Why are you sinking? Stop sinking. No, don't sink. Stand. I want to see. What is wrong with your arm? What happened to your freaking arm? Why? What is your shoulder's dislocated? What is happening? Oh, it's so gross looking. What did you do that for? Oh, there he goes. It popped it back in. No. Oh, no, it's loose. So I guess we can get a general idea. We probably need to go up a couple more pillars. So, all right, let's get that back up. And then we'll go another one. And then possibly another one after that. This high is what I'm thinking. Like so. Now, let's grab a couple more pillars off of tonnage here, because I'm thinking what we're gonna do in this early area. Let's just grab half of those guys, 12. We should be able to carry them. And I'm thinking it won't obstruct anything if we start. Yeah, I think some pillars right here too will be good. So we'll make a little like framework, so to speak. And then it was one more. I think that's as high as we want to go. Like so. Like that. And then we can put a ceiling all over the entirety of this area. Except for obviously over where the elevator is. And I am going to try to. I think we'll try that right away. Are you flying slow right now? Nah, not really. You're amazing. You don't fly slow. All right, let's grab some of these guys like this. And then we'll come over here. Closer. Closer. And then want to do like that. And I just want to make sure that, again, we're not going to get our elevator hung up. That's something that we want to kind of double check a few times here. So let's see. One there, like that. And we should probably go all the way around. So we would do, oh, crapo. Let's come over here. Nailed it. Oh, wait, we need more. Here we go. This is so difficult. Oh, you know what we'll do? This will be a lot easier if we just land. Like so. And then can I... No, no, don't die! Oh, all right. I'm going to build a little thing and test the elevator and I'll BRB's peeps. And we're back and the screen might be red because I fell down a few times, but just disregard it. All right, guys, let's take a look here and see the test. Will it pass through? I feel like we have to test everything in Ark now when we're rebuilding just to see. Are you going to stop? Is something going to happen? Nailed it, Aston! Can't be stopped! It's going up. All right, and we can stop right here. All right, let's de-elevate. And, oh, baby, it goes through! So is this an elevator or a de-elevator? It's a really good question. Oh, and we can stop it, like, exactly where we want. Oh, that's neat. So we can actually now build this bad boy out, like so. Wait, what? No, don't. Why? You shouldn't build up there. Do I have an option to have you build a little bit lower, please? Let's demolish this thatch ceiling. Oh, better. Nailed it, Ace. It can't be stopped. Now we can place all of this. And I like kind of doing this out of thatch in the first place. You know, kind of doing everything in thatch first. No, wrong. Incorrect. Because of this. Because this way I can just place it. Wait, what? That wasn't even... Why do you hate your slip gator? Why would you even do that? I guess we're going to have to do this. No, why? Oh, no. And the elevator's up there. We're screwed. But what I was saying is I love that we can build it out of thatch first, and then that way if we make a mistake it's just so much less expensive this way, guys. All right, can I break this and then fall to my not death without not dying? Oh. I did it. All right, so we got to get back up there. We'll use stupid big pigeon. We need to eat some food too. One more placement, one more piece, and we'll be done the ceiling over here. All right, ready? Nailed it, Ace, it can't be stopped. So now we can de-elevate and jump off of there, get on stupid pigeon, get tonnage, fly him down, and we've actually got like a thing. Wait, what? Did I just take damage? Oh, it looked like I did for a second because I was red already. So we've actually got like a real thing going on here. Like we actually can come up in here now. We actually have, like, this is what I'm planning as to be our storage area. I'm thinking we're going to fit 3 vaults on each side. And this will be the initial kind of area for storage of things like materials for building, basically. Wood, thatch, fiber, stone, those sorts of things will all be housed here. And then up on the above areas here, like I was saying, over on that side, will you please elevate? We're going to have a refining forge type area. All of our metal stuff and things will be over there. Up top here, I'm thinking like the bedroom stuff and all that stuff too, but then storage in here for blueprints and those sorts of things, like items that we don't have a ton of that I can't even think of, things like weapons, armor, stuff like that. That'll be all housed up into this early type area. But I like how things are turning out. It looks pretty cool. Ooh, oh, baby. De-elevate. And we're back. Look how cool this is. I'm not sure if you guys know, or some of you guys may or may not know, because you have or have not used elevators, but when you are mounted and you get on the elevator and you hit E, you can just, like, you don't have to get off. Like, it'll just elevate you. But I had an idea. Oh, this is scary. This is a little bit scary. Don't fall. Oh, stop it. Don't. All right. So we're going to move William Shatner over here. We're going to de-elevate. I have a bit of an idea, something I want to try out. We're going to see what happens here, but I want to try to stack some dinos on top of each other. I can't wait to try this out. I'm not going to tell you guys more about it. I'm going to see what happens. I'll be reviews. All right, now I'm going to bring hardware to the top, I think. This is so difficult. Let me see here. Okay. This shouldn't be a thing. This is so awesome. All right. We're going to bring hardware up and then. Oh my God. Stuff and things are going to happen, peeps. And we're back. And I have stacked hardware, kind of. It's kind of sketchy there. on top of slow mobility. And now I will attempt to make the triple stack and stack William Shatner on top of hardware, who is stacked on top of slow mobility. Can it be done? No one has ever attempted such a feat. Can I even walk on here? Because it's really weird. All right, no. Looks like that's that hardware's move. There he goes. Oh no! Oh! What was that? Oh, we're on. Wait, are we? What is happening?
Okay. Let's see what's happening. De-elevate. Come down. Did we do it? I can't see. No. But we did something. Hold on, let's see what happened.
Oh, these guys don't like it at all. We got William Shatner on the top of slow mobility, though. Look at it. It's amazing. Oh, Jaws got killed. But Hardware didn't make it. I don't know whose guy Jaws is, but it looks like a little guy. Hardware didn't quite make it. He's a little hung up over here. Can we get on you, homie? We'll figure it out. We'll have to get him off. But we did this, which is definitely a thing. Dinosaur stacking. Who would have ever thought you could get a guy on a Bronto? I really wish I could get Hardware on the back of there, too. Maybe I could just walk him off. That'd probably be easier. But I don't know. That was crazy. This is crazy cool. It's pretty fun. All right. But yeah, guys, that's going to be it for today. I had a really good time hanging out, doing some building, dinosaur stacking. I hope that you guys did too. If you liked the video, please don't forget to show your support. Hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite the videos you see fit. May the stuff and things be.